Hello anatomy friends, this is Dr. Alsup, and in this video we will be discussing the popliteal fossa. When I think popliteal, I think knee region. And these actually have some similarities to the cubital fossa we discussed in the elbow region, but now we're in the knee. So our primary objective is just to understand where this popliteal fossa is located, and also to understand the organization of the fairly large neurovasculature within the fossa. So we are looking at a posterior view of the knee region, and when you look at a living individual, it's that slight kind of diamond-like depression in the back of the knee that is covering the popliteal fossa. So try putting your hand behind your knee right now, or in that posterior portion of your knee, and that is the popliteal fossa. The fossa is bound by muscle tendons. Specifically, we're going to have hamstring muscles superiorly. So here is going to be those medial hamstring muscles and your lateral hamstring muscle, biceps femoris. And then it's also going to be bound by the two heads of the gastrocnemius or the gastrocnemius, which is one of your calf muscles. So these are both gastrocnemius here. And before dissection, this area is filled with a great degree of adipose tissue or fat to protect the structures traveling within. And you can see this is going to be some fairly large neurovasculature that's traversing between the thigh and the leg. So let's talk about that neurovasculature. Again, these are fairly large structures that are organized in a pretty typical fashion, from superficial to deep, or you can think of it from posterior to anterior. Let's think through these structures. So the most superficial, other than of course fascia and some smaller cutaneous nerves and veins, will be the sciatic nerve. And it will be fairly superiorly within the popliteal fossa. So you can see the sciatic nerve here. And it will divide into its two terminal branches, if it hasn't already done so. There's some variation there. Sometimes it can split quite a bit higher. The larger and more medial terminal branch is going to be the tibial nerve. And to me, it's usually the most prominent thing you can see here until you've done a very deep dissection. The smaller and more lateral nerve is the common fibular, sometimes referred to as the common peroneal nerve. You will hear either term. Intermediate in depth, but I would describe still kind of on the deeper side, is the popliteal vein. You can see the vein here. And deepest of all will be the popliteal artery. And when I say deep, I mean deep. It is so deep that it's actually kind of sitting on the surface of the posterior femur. So you have to do quite a bit of dissection and quite a bit of removal of fat to get to it. You can feel a popliteal pulse, but it's difficult just due to the depth. Sometimes if you flex the knee and kind of really put your hand in there, you can feel it. But again, it's a very deep artery. Oftentimes in dissection, one will say they can only find one vascular structure, and that is typically because the popliteal vein and artery are often wrapped very tightly together in fascia. So rest assured, if you further dissect, you can separate the structures, and the popliteal vein will be a little more superficial with the popliteal artery deepest. Right at the border of the popliteal fossa, the popliteal artery will divide into its terminal branches, the anterior and posterior tibial arteries, which will supply the anterior and posterior compartments of the leg. So the anterior tibial artery will kind of dive over the interosseous membrane to supply that anterior compartment, and then the posterior, of course, will supply the posterior. So a fairly small area, but very important structures within. And we have reached the summary slide. I hope you will consolidate this material, and I hope this slide will help with your studying. Thank you for your time and attention here, and as always, I hope you have a great rest of your day.